and said, look, states do collapse over a long period of time. Mm. So in doing peacekeeping research, we need to go a couple of steps back and say, what are the processes and mechanisms that undermine states and that weaken states? Now, in doing that kind of research, we've now shifted on into dealing with issues of small arms and light weapons, into transnational groups, narcotics, and all those things. So our work on oil and gas in Ghana, we look at it through the preventive lens.
Yes.
So since July last year, we've been running around the Western region, for example, talking to stakeholder groups, talking to chiefs, talking to the...
But who is responsible for preparing this? I want the institutions...
Well, I mean, you see, this country is one of the few in West Africa with a multiplicity of security and intelligence.
But that's part of the problem, isn't it? Or not necessarily?
It's the leadership that is poor.
The leadership of these institutions?
It's the leadership of the institutions and the regulations governing them. Let me give you an example.
Yeah.
One of the few countries in Africa, possibly with the exception of South Africa, is Ghana, that has an intelligence and Security Services Act. That is popularly called Act 526 of 1996. Fantastic piece of document. But 15 years on, we need to look at it, because they are part of the structure that just don't work. You know, in every village or town in this country, you would find a security agent.
Is that the case?
That is the case. That who writes a report of sorts, okay, that goes to the district.
Okay, this is so from the Ministry of National Security?
No. At a district level, it's that district security council.
Yes,
it's
headed
by the district chief executive.
Right.
It's made up of the local SEPs guy, police officer, fire service, immigration, blah, 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 blah. So that's probably about 10 to 15 people all gathered around a table.
That's the committee. That's the security committee for the area.
Now, the mistake we are making is that not all these guys have been given proper security training in terms of the analysis.
But isn't that
obvious?
And
that is where the challenge is.
But that happens all the time. Why do people think anybody can do anything? You have to have people who are trained
precisely
for a thing. Because as soon as you started telling me DC and so on, that what do they know about security?
Oh, but they are the political heads.
No, I agree. They must be involved. But really, it takes more than that, doesn't
it? Yes, it certainly does. And I think one of the clearest examples of the failure of this structure, and that's why I was talking about leadership, is that in the Yendi crisis, the BNI officer was first class, sterling, solid analysis of what was developing.
But we didn't act on it.
We didn't act on it.
Why? Just the lack, the usual lack of...
Well, probably somebody didn't even read it at all.
That wow.
For this officer, he's even writing too much. We are not even too sure.
Coming back to my question, Kwesi. I'm asking you, what institution is responsible so we can pay attention for these things, to train these people, prepare them?
It comes from the district, the...
No, at the national level, I want to know.
The National Security...
Outfit.
Outfit, okay?
And
led by the National Security Council.
Yes, but there's a ministry, isn't there?
There isn't a ministry yet. You see, that is part of the game. If there is a Minister for National Security, like Mr. Totobi Kwashi,
used to be.
Then that minister is accountable to parliament.
That's the point. You have to hold somebody accountable.
Accountable. But right now, there's no substantive minister for national security.
So national security is run by who? By what? I mean...
Well, right now, it's run by the coordinator in conjunction with the National Security Council.
Wow.
Okay, but we need someone who appears before first the Parliamentary Defense Committee on Interior, and says, this is my annual report. Okay.
These are my plans. Parliament, this is my...
Parliament can then grill the person. You see, there is nothing secret about security anymore.
That's part of the problem. I mean, it's almost like...
Okay. But we seem to be caught up in the pre-1989 thinking that security must be secret, it must be confidential, must be for your eyes only, blah, 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 blah.
Champagne and pretzels, better than breakfast in bed, better than chili rellenos, better than chocolate eclairs, better than hothouse tomatoes, better than fresh Bartlett pears, better than dining a la carte, or simply gastronomic art, better than anything.
being in love.
Are you in need of credible and relevant business information to make vital decisions? Or do you wish to reach Ghana's upmarket business and consumer segment with your product and services? Subscribe to and advertise in Business and Financial Times today, Africa's leading source of credible and relevant business information. For enquiries, contact 021-785-3667 or visit www.thebftonline.com.
So you're one of those few people I hear all the time talking about security issues. I hear you on radio. Everybody defers to you and so on. Do they listen to you? Do people in authority listen to you? Are you sharing your views, your knowledge with anybody at all?
David, I'm not sure. Let me explain this. There is a basis in this, or there is a conception that, well, I've done some research, I have some knowledge, I'll go knock on ministerial doors and say, look, this is what I've got. I think that is unethical. Occasionally, I'm called and my views sought. But my views are not sought in a way that says, look, Kwesi, you are an independent-minded person. You've done this research. Can you explain aspects of it to us? What suggestions and options do you have? I think more often than not, it's, well, look, we are seeking your views. It's good, but can't you lay off a bit occasionally?
Calm down. Don't talk too much.
You know,
you say too many sensitive things.
You say too many sensitive things. Be careful of your high blood pressure. You know, and I said a lot.
They don't even take you serious.
No, they don't. But I think for me as a person, that helps my international reputation because, you know, I get jetted all around the world, first class,
doing
business
what?
Class. Doing the same thing for other governments and think tanks.
But you know, your government would like you to cool down.
Cool down for me. What did what did that singer say? Cool down for me, little nurse. Or
yes,
yes.
You're running too fast for me.
I guess I'm running a little bit too fast, but that's what it's all about.
But Kwesi, maybe it's because you frighten people. I mean, everybody says things are calm and cool, and here you are suggesting that things are not calm. It's more risky than we think. I mean, you're you know, what do they call people like you? The monger, scaremonger?
Scaremonger, yeah.
Do you get accused of that? No, really, on a serious note, yeah. I mean, could that be the problem? I mean, and are we making a mistake of thinking about you in those terms? I presume so.
Well, I think it's a terrible mistake. I don't speak what I don't write. And I don't write what I can't talk about.
But
publicly.
You're frightening us. You're frightening us. You're saying that this, there are things can break out into conflict much easier than we think.
That is conflict prevention. Conflict prevention is about proactive knowledge and the ability to use that knowledge to ensure that conflict does not break.
So you focus on what we must do to fix that as well, don't you?
I am a fixer, yes.
You are a fixer?
I am a fixer. And I've stretched my hand out to every single Ghanaian government that I'm ready to help and to support.
Doesn't matter
but
which
I'll do
government.
That you irrespective
you,
of which
you
government.
You don't get caught in that business.
I will never get caught
in Ghana
that business.
Where, when you are here, you are not there. When you are there, you are not here.
No, I just enjoy my simple food. After teaching at the police headquarters, I'm going to eat my chop bar, go to my mom, you know, eat a bit of food with her, you know. So I'm a man with very simple tastes.
Yeah.
But I've got an iron will. Because I think I'm a Ghanaian. I'm proudly Ghanaian, and I guess the best way to help this country is to be honest and truthful in my analysis and also in my policies. So,